Welcome, my dear learners, for this course on control engineering. In this final module, that is in module 5, we were discussing on board plot. In our previous lecture, we have learnt how the magnitude and phase angle plot response for the wide range of frequency variation, that is input frequency variation, can be analyzed by using logarithmic scale along an x-axis. A semi-log plot is helpful in analyzing the wide range of input frequency changes for change in magnitude and phase angle, using which I can analyze the stability of a frequency response control system. Let us solve a numerical problem in today's lecture. The problem number 1 of our discussion on board plot states that a unity feedback control system has g of s is equal to 80 divided by s of s plus 2 into s plus 20. Draw the board plot, determine gain margin, phase margin, gain crossover frequency and phase crossover frequency, comment on stability. Let us solve this problem. If I move for solution of this problem number 1, in step 1, convert this into standard time constant form. What is standard time constant form? That is, it should be in the form of the simple poles, should be in the form of 1 plus Ts, whereas the simple zeros should be in the form of 1 plus Ts. And the complex pole and complex zeros should be in the form of 1 plus 2 zeta omega n s plus s square by omega n square. So convert this into the standard form in step 1. That is, obtain standard time constant form. Standard time constant form of the given transfer function. What we have? We have g of s is equal to 80 divided by s of s plus 2 into s plus 20. Since he is stating it is a unity feedback control system, h of s is how much? 1. So therefore, what will you get? G of s into h of s? G of s into h of s is equal to this into 1 is 80 divided by s of s plus 2, 80 divided by s of s plus 2 into s plus 20. Now if you observe, we have one pole at origin, we have two simple poles, we have two simple poles and one pole at origin. Now in order to convert this into standard time constant form, we should have 1 plus Ts form for the simple poles. Hence, I should take 2 common from this first pole and 20 common from this second pole. So, if I do that and simplify, what I am going to get, that is, I will get 80 divided by S into 2, I will take common. So, this will become 1 plus s by 2. Here I will take 20 common, this will become 1 plus s by 20. So hence, if I simplify further, I will get 80 divided by 40, that is 2 divided by s of 1 plus 0.5 s, that is 1 by 2, 1 plus 0.5 s into 1 by 20, correct? 1 by 20 is how much? 0.05. So this is 1 plus 0.05 s. 1 plus 0.05 s. So I obtained the standard time constant form of the given function. So this is of the form 1 plus Ts. So now, if I compare this with the standard form, the constant k value is 2 and we have one pole at origin and we have two simple poles. Now, in step 2, discuss the factors. So, moving ahead for step 2. Step 2 is discussion of factors. So if I take first one, that is constant k Here the value of k is turning out to be 2, right? So value of k is 2, therefore it does not have any effect on the phase angle plot, but it has effect on magnitude plot. So what is it, its effect, how to represent it in the magnitude plot? In the magnitude plot, we should draw a straight line at 0 degree, and what is the magnitude? Draw a straight line of 0 degree at 20 log 10 k. How much is 20 log 10 k? Here the value of k is 2, that is 20 log 2 is nothing but 6.02. So draw a straight line of 0 degree at 20 log 10 k. So your k value is 2, hence I should get 6.02. so I should offset the magnitude plot by an amount, 6.02, positive value. Next, moving for the second, we have one pole at origin, that is 1 by s, that is 1 by s. Now for pole at origin, what is it we have? For pole at origin, draw a straight line. Draw a straight line of slope. Since it is pole, what is the slope of that line? Minus 20 dB per decade, which we have already discussed in our previous lecture. Minus 20 dB per decade intersecting intersecting 0 decibels at 1 radians per second. Why the minus 20 dB per decade line should intersect 0 dB magnitude at 1 radians per second? This is because of the reason we have already seen. For 1 by s, if I draw the magnitude plot, I will get minus 20 log 10 omega, correct? Minus 20 log 10 omega. Kindly visit our previous lecture where I clearly explained. Find the magnitude of this. Convert this into log scale. How to convert this into log scale? Use 20 log 10 k. If I use 20 log 10 k, I will get 20 log 10 1 by omega. So 1 by omega can be written as what? Log 10 of 1 minus log 10 of omega. Log 10 of 1 is 0. Leave it. Next you will get log minus log 10 of omega. So hence you will get minus 20 log 10 omega. Now put the value of omega as 1. Now if I put the value of omega as 1, minus 20 log 10 1. How much is minus 20 log 10 1? 0. So therefore this straight line should intersect 0 dB at 1 radians per second. Hope you are following it. Next, it does not have any corner frequency, right? Because it does not have time constant with it. So no corner frequency for this. So you can take the corner frequency as 0, that is for omega c greater than or equal to 0. Next, move for the third term. Here the third term is simple pole. What is that simple pole? Simple pole, that is 1 by 1 plus 0.5 s. Now how much is the time constant? T is equal to what? This is of the form 1 plus t s, hence time is 0.5 seconds. And how much is corner frequency? So corner frequency will be 1 by time period t. It is 1 by 0.5, which is nothing but 2 radians per second. Now what is the contribution of this for the magnitude plot? The straight line of simple pole contributes minus 20 dB per decade. So its contribution is also a straight line of slope minus 20 dB per decade for corner frequency greater than or equal to 2 radians per second. That is, from 0 to 2 radians per second, I will have minus 20 dB per decade. Now, I will take the resultant. Resultant is minus 20, minus 20 is minus 40. So, minus 40 will continue from 2 to next corner frequency. This is because of the reason the product of magnitudes should be cumulative value, whereas the division of magnitudes should be difference of values, because in logarithmics, the multiplication and division are replaced by addition and subtraction. That is, log of A by B is nothing but log A minus log B. Similarly, log of A into B is nothing but log A plus log B. So, wherein which if we have division, it is replaced by subtraction. If we have product, it is replaced by addition. Next, moving ahead for fourth one, we have one more simple pole. What is that simple pole? 1 by 1 plus 0.05s. So here, what is the time constant t is 0.05 seconds. And how much is corner frequency? Corner frequency is 1 by time period, which is nothing but 20 radians per second. 20 radians per second. So what is its contribution? Its contribution is also minus 20 dB per decade. So it is also a straight line of slope minus 20 dB per decade for omega c greater than 20 radians per second. 20 radians per second. So we have discussed all the factors present here. That is constant k, one pole at origin, two simple poles. Now if I plot resultant slope table, first we have factors, frequency range, and then we have resultant slope. What is the unit of resultant slope? Decibels per decade. So what is the meaning of decade? Decade is nothing but 10 divisions in the log sheet, semi-log sheet. That I will explain when I move on to plot, board plot. Now factor, first one is k, no frequency range, no slope. Next factor is 1 by s, frequency range is omega c greater than or equal to 0. Let me put it this way, greater than or equal to 0, and it should be finish it off before the next one. The next one is at 2 radians per second, so it is 0 to 2. And what is its contribution? Minus 20 dB per decade. Since we don't have any value prior to it, the cumulative value remains as it is. Next, we have 1 by 1 plus 0.5s. 1 by 1 plus 0.5s should be plotted in the range of 2 radians to 20 radians. So how much is the contribution of simple pole 1 by 1 plus 0.5s? It is also minus 20. So resultant is how much? Earlier we have minus 20, now we have minus 20. So it is minus 20 minus 20. Minus 20 minus 20 is equal to -40 dB per decade. Next, we have one more, that is 1 plus 0.05 S inverse. That is one more simple pole. What is its frequency range? It is greater than 20 up to infinity. So what is its contribution? Its contribution is also -20 dB per decade. So earlier I had -40, now contribution is -20, so resultant will be -60 dB per decade. So I got the resultant slope table. This is the resultant slope table. I got the resultant slope table. Now I can use this for magnitude plot. Next, moving ahead for step 3, that is phase angle plot. Step 3 is phase angle. Now we have to determine the phase angle. As I already said, it is nothing but tan inverse of imaginary part by real part. Now if I take the very first one, K, you should always analyze the standard form, time constant form, replace S by j omega. You should replace S by j omega, then only you can identify which is real part and which is imaginary part. So therefore, in phase angle plot, take the standard form of the given function and replace S by j omega. So if I replace S by j omega, I am going to get g of j omega into h of j omega is equal to, k is a constant, right? So it is 2 plus 0 j divided by s is j omega 1 plus 0.5 j omega and 1 plus 0.05 j omega. Here j is nothing but imaginary. It is nothing but I, imaginary part. Now, say replaced S by j omega. If I want to go for angle, phase angle phi, phi is equal to what? This is constant. Imaginary part is 0. Tan inverse of 0 by 2 is tan inverse of 0. Tan inverse of 0 is 0. So hence you can neglect that. What is the phase angle contribution of pole at origin? Pole at origin is minus 90 degrees. Which we have already discussed in our previous lecture. Or else you can also write it here. It is 1 by tan inverse of omega by 0. How much is real part? 0. This can be written as 0 plus j omega. That is 1 divided by tan inverse of omega by 0. 1 by tan inverse of omega by 0 is how much? 1 by tan inverse of infinity. 1 by tan inverse of infinity is how much? 1 by 90 degrees. How to write 1 by 90 degrees? It is nothing but minus 90 degree. Next, here, since this is in denominator, I should take it as minus tan inverse of imaginary part by real part. Real part is 1. How much is imaginary part? Imaginary part is 0.5 omega minus tan inverse of, how much is imaginary part? 0.05 omega divided by real part is 1. So I got the phase angle formula. So this is the formula you should use to calculate the phase angle. For denominators, you should use minus. For numerators, it is plus. And one more important note I forgot to mention in the resultant slope table, you should note down the factors in the increasing order of the corner frequency. Kindly make a note of it. Because whenever you arrange the factors in the increasing order of their corner frequency, you can see here, corner frequency is 0, corner frequency is 2, corner frequency is 20, correct? So whenever you arrange in the increasing order of corner frequency, then the accumulation, the resultant will be properly arranged. If not, it will be missed and you will be get confused or you will stuck in the building of magnitude plot table. So therefore, always you should note down the factors in the increasing order of their corner frequency. That is, I have taken from 0 to 20. It is in the increasing order. So therefore, I have not done anything. Just I have noted down directly. Because by default, they are in increasing order of their corner frequencies. Now let us move on. I was addressing phase angle plot. Now if I vary omega, I'll get phi. My aim here is to determine the phase crossover frequency. What do you mean by phase crossover frequency? Phase crossover frequency is the frequency at which the phase angle plot reaches -180 degree. -180 degree is the meaning of phase crossover frequency, correct? Now at what frequency I'll get phi is equal to -180 degree is the question to be answered. Instead of guessing the value, what I will do, I'll solve this equation for -180 degree and I'll come to know what is the phase crossover frequency immediately. Then accordingly I'll build the table. That gives us very good intuition for the problem. But actual procedure is that you should use the value of omega and find at what omega you will get -180 degree. But what I'm telling you is that put phi is equal to -180 and find at what omega you are getting -180. That omega is nothing but phase crossover frequency. So what I'm telling is nothing but do it like this. Take it as -180 plus 90. I'm taking that -90 to LHS, it will become +90. Alpha is equal to minus tan inverse of 0.5 into alpha x bracket close, again minus shift tan inverse of 0.05 into alpha x bracket close, shift solve is equal to. So how much you are getting? The value of omega as 6.324. So what is the phase crossover frequency? Phase crossover frequency is 6.32. You can verify how I have written. So just type the equation by replacing omega by x, and if you press shift to solve is equal to, it will solve and give you the answer. Omega is 6.324. So I got the answer without plotting the graph, that is omega is equal to 6.324. So therefore I will build accordingly. So I'll vary the value of omega, I'll find the value of phi. I'll vary the value of omega, I'll find phi. I'll vary the value of omega, I'll find phi. What is the exact answer? Exact answer is 6.325. So build the line for phase angle plot, that is 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.5. Here it is 1, 2, 3. Since I am getting the answer as 6.325, let me go with 6 and 7. 6, 7. Here I will go with tens. 10, 20, 50, 100. Now for these values, you find out the corresponding values of phi. So between 6 and 7, I will get -180 degree. So we have phi is equal to -90 minus tan inverse of 0.5 into 0.1 minus tan inverse of 0.05 into 0.1. So I am starting with -93. Then we have 0.2. For 0.2, you are going to get -96. For 0.3, you are going to get the value as -99. For 0.5, you are going to get the value as -105. For 1, you are going to get the value as -119 degrees. For 2, you are going to get the value as -141 degrees. For 3, you are going to get the value as -155. For 6, phi is -178. You can see here we are approaching minus 180. What is the exact answer? 6.35. For 7, we are getting minus 183. So this, why I took 5 as minus 180 and solved initially is because I want to know till what point I should build the table. So it will give you an idea till what point I should build the table. You should build the table before and after 180 degree. So after 180 degree, let get me 3 or 4 points. Before 180 degree, get me 3 or 4 points. That's what I require to plot face angle on the semi-log sheet. So similarly, you continue for 10 to 100. For 100, you are going to get minus 258. So this completes the face angle plot table. So using this, I can plot the face angle in the semi-log sheet. So this is the table required for face angle plot. For various values of omega, I tabulated various values of phi. From the table, it is evident that the phase crossover occurs at between 6 and 7 radians per second, but you know the exact answer, it is 6.35 radians per second. Therefore, without plotting the board plot, we determined what is the value of omega PC, phase crossover frequency. So this is the step number 3. Now step number 4 is board plot. So these are the 4 steps you should follow to get the solution for the problem. Come, let us draw board plot. Now moving ahead for solution of problem number 1. So this is the semi-log sheet. In step 4, I want to plot the board attenuation plot. For problem number 1, so far we have determined the magnitude plot as well as phase angle plot. This is what we have determined so far. Moving ahead for step number 4, I want to go for board attenuation plot. Since this is problem number 1, let me explain the semi-log sheet properly. So this is the semi-log sheet what we have. Here itself we can see it is a semi-log paper written, and what I explained in our lecture 1, decades, so these are called decades. From here to here it is one decade, from here to here it is another decade, from here to here it is another decade. So therefore totally we have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 decade. This is a 5 decade semi-log sheet. So here also you can see it is marked from 1 to 1. It is, every decade is marked from 1 to 1. So x-axis is in logarithmic sheet, logarithmic scale, and y-axis is linear scale. Now you want to build the lines with slopes what we have computed. The resultant slope, if you observe, we have the lines as minus 20 decibels per decade, minus 40 decibels per decade, and minus 60 decibels per decade. So therefore I want to construct lines of slopes minus 20, minus 40, and minus 60. Now how to construct these lines and how to plot magnitude as well as phase angle in the same semi-log paper is the question. You have to do that, if you observe carefully, lines having negative slope. So if I construct a straight line like this, this is a line having positive slope, correct? So similarly, if I construct line like this, so this is a line having negative slope. You can take dy by dx of this line. So this line will have negative slope, whereas this line will have positive slope, correct? If I take dy by dx, this line will have positive slope. So what I mean to say, a line AB has positive slope, whereas line A dash B dash has negative slope. Line moving towards the fourth quadrant will have negative slope, line moving towards first quadrant will have positive slope from the origin of a Cartesian coordinate if I plot. So now I want lines like this with slopes of minus 20, minus 40 and minus 60 decibels per decade. Now how to do that is the question. Now in order to construct that, we already know that the magnitude plot of 1 by s is what? Minus 20 log 10 omega, correct? Minus 20 log 10 omega. How I obtained this? Substitute s is equal to j omega. If I substitute s is equal to j omega, what I will get? 1 by j omega. So magnitude is square root of real part square plus imaginary part square. So it is square root of real part is 0, imaginary part is omega. So hence the magnitude will be 1 by omega. Now in log scale this should be written as what? Minus 20 log 10 omega. This is in linear scale and this is in log scale. Correct? This is the magnitude of 1 by s. Right? Now this I have already explained to you people in our first lecture, that is introductory lecture of board plot. Now we know magnitude of 1 by s is minus 20 log 10 omega. Now put omega is equal to 1. So if I put omega is equal to 1, what happens? For omega is equal to 1 radians per second, what happens? Minus 20 log 10 of 1. So log 10 of 1 is how much? 0. So therefore I'll get the magnitude as 0. Correct? Which means that the minus 20 decibels per decade line will intersect the magnitude 0 at omega is equal to 1. So using this information, minus 20 decibels per decade line intersects the magnitude of 0 decibels at 1 radians per second. Use this information. Minus 20 decibels per decade line with magnitude of 0 decibels intersecting at omega is equal to 1 radians per second will gives us the line of minus 20 dB per decade. Now using this information, I can construct the slopes of minus 20, minus 40 and minus 60 decibels per decade. Now come, let us do board plot for problem number 1. So here if you observe in the magnitude plot, the highest what I have is minus 60. You know, to generate minus 60, I should mark plus 60. Why I want plus 60, that also I will explain. Now to generate minus 60 decibels per decade, first you start marking from plus 60 dB. That is, here for magnitude plot, I will mark it as plus 60. Then I will mark it as plus 40. Then I will mark it as plus 20. Then 0. Then we will get minus 20. Then we will get minus 40. Let me do till this point. Now in the log sheet, if you carefully observe, the log sheet does not have 0. It is starting from 1 to 1. Each decade starts from 1, ends with 1. That's what here he has written in the log sheet, correct? So therefore I should start from 1 to 10 or 11 to 100 or 101 to 1000. Like that I should go. So therefore let me start with 0.1. If I start with 0.1 till I can go to 1, right? Instead of which I will write it as 10 to the power of 0. 0.1, 10 to the power of 0, then 10 to the power of 1, then 10 square, then 10 cube, then 10 to the power of 4. Like this I will write. So it is 0.1, 10 to the power of 0 is 1, 10 to the power of 1 is 10, 10 square is 100, 10 cube is 1000, and 10 to the power of 4 is 10,000. So this is nothing but what? Frequency. X-axis is frequency in log scale. This is frequency. Now as I said, in magnitude plot 0 dB is the reference, whereas in phase angle plot minus 180 degree is the reference. So therefore draw a straight line at 0 decibels. So we have 0 decibels here. So from 0 decibels you draw a straight line and take it as a reference. For that let me use different color. Let me use blue. I am constructing the reference line at 0 decibels. I am constructing the reference line at 0 decibels. Constructed a reference line at 0 decibels. Now as I said just now, you have to generate the slopes of minus 20 decibels. The line of minus 20 decibel intersect the magnitude plot at 0 dB
when omega is equal to 1 radians per second. Now where is omega is equal to 1 radians per second? This is 10 power 0. 10 power 0 is 1. This is 1 radians per second. Where is magnitude plot 0? Here it is 0. This is magnitude of 0 when omega is equal to 1. Correct? So therefore, the line of minus 20 dB should pass this point. Hence, to generate that, connect plus 20 to 1. Connect plus 20 to 1. That will give you minus 20 dB per decade line. So connect plus 20 to 1. Like this. This line is nothing but minus 20 decibels per decade line. Similarly, generate minus 40 decibels per decade line. Connect minus 40 to 1 like this. So similarly, you generate minus 60 also. So for minus 60 also, I can construct like this. So thereby, I constructed the lines of minus 20 dB per decade, minus 40 dB per decade, and minus 60 dB per decade. We got the lines. Similarly, if I want plus 20, plus 40, plus 60, then you should join minus 20 to this point, minus 40 to this point, and minus 60 to this point. So then those lines will give you plus 20 dB per decade, plus 40 dB per decade, plus 60 dB per decade. Now using positive values, I generated negative slopes. So these are minus 20 dB per decade, minus 40 dB per decade, and minus 60 dB per decade lines. So hope you are following. This is minus 60 decibels per decade line. Minus 60 decibels per decade line, and this is minus 40 dB per decade line, and similarly this is minus 20 dB per decade line. Now using which I can construct the magnitude plot. What does magnitude plot says? We have the first one, that is from frequency range 0 to 2, from frequency range 0 to 2, that is minus 20 decibels per decade line will begin. Before that, I should shift this minus 20 decibels per decade to 20 log 10 K line. That is the system gain that is available for us. Correct? For the change of K, I am verifying whether the system is stable or unstable. What is the value of K we have? What is the value of K we have? K is 20. Correct? So therefore, K is 2. Hence, what is the shift? What is the shift? Shift is 20 log 10 K. That is 20 log 10 2. How much is 20 log 10 2? How much is 20 log 10 2? 20 log 10 2 is 6. So which is nothing but 6 decibels. Which is nothing but 6 decibels. So therefore, shift the reference from 0 dB to 6 dB. From 0 dB to 6 dB. So that is a gain or change you are incorporating to your system, and verifying for that change whether the system is stable or unstable. So therefore, how much is the change? 6 decibels. So therefore, count 6 decibels. Now each unit, I took it as 20 decibels. So therefore, each segment of each unit, this much. This segment is how much? Totally we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines. 5 lines for 20 dB. Therefore, one line is how much? Correct, 4 dBs, correct? So one line is how much? This one line accomplishes 4 decibels because each unit is 20 decibels. So for 6 decibels, how much I should take? 1.5. For 6 decibels, I should take 1.5. Now shift the reference from 0 to 6 decibels. Shift the reference from 0 to 6 decibels. So I'm shifting the reference from 0 to 6 decibels. Like this. You shift the reference. So I took the reference as 20 log 10 of k. Value of k is 2, right? Sorry, value of k is 2. So 20 log 10 2, which is nothing but 66 decibels. 20 log 10 k, 20 log 10 2 is equal to 6 decibels. I shifted the reference from 0 to 6 decibels. Now start the problem. Plot the magnitude. First is minus 20 decibels, range is 0 to 2 radians per second. Now I have the 20 decibels per decade line. Now shift it first. Shift it to the 6 decibels line. So this is intersecting at 1 radian per second to 0 decibels, but actual reference is 6 decibels. So shift it to 6 decibels. That is, it will shift here, correct? 6 decibels. Now I have shifted, which is nothing but draw parallel line for that. Shifted. Done. Now this is 20 decibels per decade, which is parallel to minus 20 decibels per decade line, which I have already generated. So this is minus 20 decibels per decade line. Minus 20 decibels per decade line. Shifted. Now this should vary from 0 to 2 radians per second. Where is 2? So this is 1 and this is 2, correct? This is 10 to the power of 0 is 1. This is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Next 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 80, 90, 100. Next 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 1000. Next 2000, 3000, 4000, like that we should go. That is what we have in the x-axis. If this is 1, then this is 2. So it should extend till 2 radians per second, correct? So therefore, extend this till 2 radians per second. Extend this till 2 radians per second. I think 2 radians per second itself is our gain cross our frequency. That is the magnitude plot crossing 0 dB line. So I extended this line till 2 radians per second. Now, what is next? Next we have minus 40 dB per decade from 2 to 20. From 2 to 20. Now draw parallel line for minus 40 dB per decade. So this is minus 40 dB per decade, correct? This is minus 40 dB per decade line. Take parallel for this. Take parallel for this. If you use roller scale, it will be better. Use roller scale for much accurate answers. So draw parallel to minus 40 dB per decade. Start from 2 to 20. 2 to 20 means till what? This is 10, this is 20. Which means I should plot till here. 20. So draw parallel to minus 40 dB per decade from 2 to 20. Next. What is next? Next is minus 60 from 20 to infinity. Now draw parallel to 60 dB per decade line, starting from end of minus 40 dB per decade line till infinity. So draw parallel for this. I'll take a parallel for this, and this should extend till infinity. So I'll draw till certain amount. So this completes the magnitude plot. Now the magnitude line where it intersects the 0 dB per decade is the gain crossover frequency. For this problem, if you observe, the magnitude plot is intersecting the 0 dB line at here, which is nothing but 2 radians per second. Hence, for this problem, the gain crossover frequency omega GC is 2 radians per second. You can observe at 2 radians per second, the magnitude plot is crossing 0 dB line. Now similarly, I should plot magnitude plot. So for magnitude plot, let me start from minus 90, minus 90 degree. Each unit, I'll take it as 30 degrees. So minus 90, minus 120 degree, minus 150 degree. Then we have minus 180 degree, minus 210 degree. Then we have minus 240 degree minus 270 degree. Each unit I will take it as 30 degrees. Then each line will be how much? 6 degrees, correct? For 30 degrees it is 5 lines. For each line it will be 6 degrees because 6 5 is 30. Now mark the points. That is, for 0.1 it is minus 93. For 0.1 it is minus 93. It is between minus half of one line. Next we have for 0.2 it is 96. This is 0.1, this is 0.2. For 0.2 it is 96. 96. Next, for 0.3 it is 99, minus 99. For 0.3 it is 99. Next, for 0.5, 105. For 0.5, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5. For 0.5 it is 105. It is 96, 102, 105. Next, for 1 it is minus 119. This is 1, correct? For 1 radians per second, it is minus 119, it's just above 120, minus 120, done. Next, for 2, it is minus 141, for 2 radians per second, it is minus 141, so 150 minus 6 is 144, let me mark here. Next, 1 minus 155 for 3, for 3 radians per second, it is 155. Next, for 6 it is minus 178. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. For 6. For 6 it is minus 178. And for 7 it is minus 183. For 7 it is minus 183. And for 10 it is minus 195. For 10 it is minus 195. 180, 186, 192, 192, we want 195, mark in between, 195. Next we have for 20, 219, 1020, for 20, 219, it will be here. Next for 50, 246, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, for 50, it is 246. It is 246. And for 100 it is minus 258. For 100 it is minus 258. 240, 246, 252, 252, 258. Done. Now for these omegas we got phi plotted. Now draw a smooth curve. Draw a smooth curve passing through these points, that will give you the magnitude plot like this. Draw a smooth curve. Done. So we got phase angle plot also. Now for phase angle plot, what is the reference? For phase angle plot, minus 180 degree is the reference, correct? So mark the reference at minus 180 degree. We draw the reference. Done. Now the frequency at which the phase angle plot crosses minus 180 is called phase crossover frequency, which is very difficult from here to analyze. It is coming between 6 and 7. That I know, it is coming between 6 and 7. How much is the exact answer? That we have already, I have already explained when I explained in the board. So this is the equation we have. If I solve this equation, I will get the answer right. Minus 180 plus 90. Take this to RHS. This must be equal to minus tan inverse of 0.5 into alpha x minus tan inverse of 0.05 into alpha x. Shift solve is equal to. So I'll get the answer as 6.3245. So hence the phase cross of frequency is 6.32. And also you can observe from here in the plot also, between 6 and 7 it is crossing minus 180 degree line. So hence from there if you drop you can write that omega phase crossover frequency is 6.3 radians per second, whereas omega GC, omega gain crossover frequency is here. So this is omega gain crossover frequency. That is the frequency at which the magnitude plot is crossing 0 dB line. This is the frequency at which the phase angle plot is crossing minus 180 degree line. We got gain crossover frequency, we got phase crossover frequency. Now as I explained, use phase crossover frequency to measure gain margin. Use gain crossover frequency to measure phase margin. Now first let me use phase crossover frequency to measure gain margin. That is, extend this back and intersect the zero reference line, that is between 6 and 7. Extended. Now measure this distance from here to here. Now if I measure, I'm getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 4.5 lines. So if I measure, I'm getting 4.5 lines. That is from zero reference line to the magnitude plot line at phase crossover frequency, I'm getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 4.5 lines approximately. Each line is how much? 4 decibels. So 4.5 into 4 is what I'm getting. 4.5 into 4 is nothing but 18 decibels. So therefore, gain margin is turning out to be plus 18 decibels. Because each line is 4 decibels, I am getting 4.5 lines. So how much is 4.5 into 4? It is 18 decibels. Always remember, from the zero line, if you measure downward, the GM is positive. Gain margin is positive. If you measure from zero reference line upward, then gain margin is negative. Opposite to this is phase margin. If you measure phase margin above minus 180 reference line, then phase margin is positive. If you measure the phase margin below minus 180 degree line, then phase margin is negative. Now if you observe the phase angle plot line and the minus 180 degree line, if I measure, it is coming above minus 180 degree line. Therefore phase margin is also positive for this case. And how much is the phase margin? And phase margin here, that is from the phase angle plot to minus 180 degree. If I measure this distance, if I measure, this is approximately how many lines? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6.5 lines I am getting. 6.5 lines. Here, in case of phase angle plot, each unit is 30 degree and one subunit of each unit is how much? For 5 lines, I am taking 30 degrees. So therefore, for one line, it is 6 degrees. How many lines I am getting? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.5. 6.5 into 6 degrees. 6.5 into 6 degrees, which is approximately 39 degrees is the phase margin that I am getting for this problem. So the phase margin PM, phase margin is plus 39 degrees. If I list out the results for this problem, the results are, what are the results? First one is, I calculated the gain crossover frequency. Gain crossover frequency is found to be 2 radians per second, using which I calculated the, using gain cross of frequency, I calculated phase margin, which is turning out to be 39 degree. Next, we found phase cross over frequency as 6.3 radians per second, using which we calculated gain margin. How much is gain margin? Gain margin is plus 18 decibels. Plus 18 decibels. If you observe, both are positive, right? Phase margin is also positive. Gain margin is also positive. Hence, the system is absolutely stable. System is absolutely stable. So therefore, we have analyzed the stability of the system. Both phase margin and gain margin are positive for us. Hence, the system is absolutely stable. Now, apart from this, you nicely mark the range of magnitude and phase angle plot. So this is a reference I took, right? So from here till bottom, I took this as phase angle. From the top till here, I took it as magnitude plot. This is magnitude in dB. Magnitude in decibels, whereas this is phase angle in degrees. Phase angle in degrees. And x-axis is frequency in radians per second. Radians per second. What else is left out for this? Next is scale, correct? I not written the scale. Let me write scale here. The scale for y-axis, magnitude. For y-axis magnitude, I took one unit as 20 decibels, and for phase angle, I took one unit as 30 degrees. So this is the scale we have, and this is the solution for problem number 1, which is nothing but g of s is equal to 80 divided by s plus 2 into s plus 20. So for the problem, that is open loop transfer function, g of s is equal to 80 by s of s plus 2 into s plus 20. So this is the board plot. From the board plot, we have determined that the gain crossover frequency is 2 radians per second. Using gain crossover frequency, I calculated gain margin. Using gain crossover frequency, I calculated phase margin, which is turning out to be plus 39 degree. And later we calculated phase crossover frequency. Phase crossover frequency is turning out to be 6.3 radians per second. Using phase crossover frequency, I calculated gain margin, which is plus 18 dB. Since both gain margin as well as phase margin, both are positive, the system is absolutely stable. Absolutely stable. This is the complete solution for problem number 1. That's all from this lecture. Thank you all.